Often when you have seen an interesting space or a piece of art, or when you've seen a wonderful play, then when you go home, then something else stays in the mind. In a building, to achieve that, you do have to create several layers of readings you find in the building. Project in Almere, when you step into the courtyard, the different colors turn into a time machine where you have yellow time, green time. If you are walking then in these different times, you then are also walking into a different complex set of images. If you take the Seoul building, this kaleidoscopic aspect with light behind the facade, what changes continuously creates these after images when you walk away from it. People remember it as something what lights up the street in such a manner that it creates an image of an urban effect. In the latest work, this is not anymore seen as purely something related to the facade alone, but it is a textural element becoming far more complex sculptural principle going into the whole building. You see that in the latest Louis Vuitton building, where one pattern is used not only into the facade and the plan, but in a diagonal manner, so that the patterns come very complex. You find it in the Louis Vuitton building, you find it in the Busan towers, where the towers look like if there are three or four towers in one tower, but there's only one tower. We have the Aarhus project, where living with a view is this landscape quality what is making this facade different than, let's say, a traditional facade. This is making the whole project work, this big detail, but the simplicity of it is to be found behind it. In the Hong Kong project, in this design school, we rethought the principle of educating design. Many aspects of teaching is related to the organization of the building also, but that whole complex principle is also related to the way the building is organized and looks like. It's not about the architecture what you bring home, it's more the spatial experience that you take home, and that's maybe the essence of the after image. I think as architects we work with the future. I need to predict sometimes what can happen over 5 years, because before the design is designed, it takes maybe 1 year, 2 years, and before it is built, it takes another 2 years. So we need to be the future.